because the navigation is still being defined. I mean, like if you ask me, right? I mean, like the other thing is, just give me one
Okay,
moment.
so
Sorry for interrupting. Just give me one minute. I want to show you this one. Maybe that you can think it from that point. Okay, just give me one minute. I mean, like we have we have this car, right? The manage home.
Give me a second.
Yeah, so if you see this manage home, we have it in the TLIF, correct? For the Magenta also, that they're bringing up the same kind of screen for the Metro also. And
Okay.
they will have a pay bill kind of thing on this one. Let's say, for example, like I mean, assume this is the pay, let's say the pay now or set up auto pay, for example, right?
Okay, let's say this is a card which is kind of different than what we have in T-Life. In T-Life, what we have is on the right side, and on the let's say Metro, we have things on the left side. One of the things we can do is we can the card you see in my account right now, you can modify it in a way that it looks similar to this one, but that would require a lot of if and else, right? The other we can do it is we can create a view which is a new view for the Magenta. So this card would be a new card. Now within the landing controller, right? So if you see in code, there is a action landing controller in which all these different cards are being added to a view model, checking whether it should be enabled or disabled, right? If I tell you which file it is
I'm not able to open the code. I mean, like maybe you want to share your screen, maybe, because like I don't have the code with me, because it's in Rakesh or maybe you want them to share.
Sure, I'll share.
Okay, or maybe I mean, like what I can do is, do you want me to export this and give it to you so that you can have both at the same time, so that you can reference to export these two as PDF and give it to you. Let me stop the screen share, and I'll while you're bringing up your screen share, I'll export this to you as a PDF. Okay.
So is my screen visible to you guys?
Yes, Ashish. Yeah.
Perfect. So,
and sorry, just give me one second. Let me just give you that share the attachment so that you have the result reference basically. Okay, yeah, go ahead. I'll attach it later. Yeah.
Sure. So, the screen that you see right now, which is the home page screen. I don't know if I have that attachment right now or not.
Yeah, not yet. I'm gonna let me send it here.
Yeah, it's still not here. But okay, let it come, and then I would be able to explain more easily.
Yeah. Somehow I'm not seeing the attach option. Just give me 1 minute on this one. I don't know why.
Oh, you might not be able to attach it because it is an external thing.
Oh, okay. It's a possibility. Okay. Let me email it to you. I'm not sure like why it's not showing me to. I don't mean to do that, but yeah.
Till that screen is getting attached, let me try to explain it here.
Yeah,
so what we are doing is on the action landing, which is action landing is basically the screen which is the home page, the screen that you just saw, which has all these different cards. That is action landing presenter. Now within action landing presenter, what we are doing right here is fetch action landing dashboard data. Is we are trying to fetch all these different views. So you see there are different fetch magenta card view, fetch messaging view, fetch banner widget view, wallet widget view. Then there is the deals and rewards header. There is kids watch card. There is scam shield card. All these different cards. Then there is router cards as well. Now if you see all of these cards which are being fetched has a condition called whether it is enabled or not. Is image widget enabled on home or not? Now if we go to this, you would see that this is basically in the interactor we have this enable home widget widget on home, right? Now let me go to interactor and check. So this is here we are returning it from data provider. Now data, what data provider does is this is action data provider. What action data provider does is action data provider checks from CMS whether that value is enabled or not, and it returns us that value. Now if that value is true, we would be showing that card. If that value is false, we would not show that card. Now imagine you have this feature flag in your CMS portal. It would be there for magenta as well as metro. So now what we can do is we can enable for this particular feature. What you would want first thing would be a feature flag which would be in the home module. It would be called either metro payment, metro bill payment, or anything like that. This feature flag, it would have an option whether it is enabled, dot enabled, and it would return us a boolean value true or false. If it is true, we would be showing that card. If it is false, we would not show that card. This would have a false value on the TLife app. It would have a true value on the Magenta app. On the Magenta app, if it is true, we would render that in the we would fetch it through data provider in the interactor. Interactor would tell it basically to presenter. Presenter would have all this business logic whether we have to show or not. It would add it in our view model, and through view model it would be rendered on the screen. Does that make sense? Is that something you guys follow?
Yeah, I think I got that one. Rakesh and Naveel need.
Yeah,
from,
I got it.
Naveel, you guys got it, right? Yeah. So, just to be clear, right? I mean, like, that whole, if you, oh, can you open that? Yeah, open the body.png.
Yeah,
that one is the home page. This is a body.png. Oh, yeah. Open the body.png, of course. I mean, like, yeah, this is the payment. Can you open, yeah, can you open the body.png? Yeah, because, I think what happened is when I exported it, means some, yeah. So let's say, for example, the top card, right? The payment card.
Yeah, this particular card.
Yeah,
so what you would do is you would create a component similar to what we have. All these components, like if you see this page, all these are components. Message widget component. So these are different widget components that we have created. You can go through the code and see how these components are created and. So all these different components are being resolved in different modules. So one of the component is in let's say, give me a second, modules. So one of them is in connect module. The kids watch component is in connect module. The router one is in HSI, some are in billing. So there are different components. So if whichever module, let's say you are working in billing module, right? There's a billing card. You make those components in the billing module, you resolve them here and add it to the presenter. You have your feature flag enabled or disabled, whether it should be shown for metro or not. So those feature flags would be taken care of, and then you would be able to render this particular card. Right. And on the click of this, what would happen is you would open your screens.
Sorry for interrupting, Ashish. So just to be clear, right? The feature flags are for the components, right? Not the individual elements of it, right?
Sorry, can you repeat
the,
that?
The feature flags, I mean, like whether it is enabled or not, is for the complete component, correct?
Yeah, it is for the component. You can have it as creative as you want it to be. Let's say you want to create a feature flag for this particular button, whether it should be shown or not. If you are enabling it, it would be shown. If you want to disable it, it would be hidden. So you can have a feature flag for this. You can have a feature flag for this. You can have a feature flag whether you want to show this active or not. So that is up to you and business logic, how much configurable you want to make this.
Okay. And right. Just to be clear, right? I mean, like, just for example, like this particular screen, I mean, like, it is almost similar to the what we have on the magenta side, the current TI. This different is this, the top component, right? The upcoming payment, that particular piece. So we just create a feature flag and for this component, and we just enable this for the metro only. It should be
whole screen would be similar. Whichever things you want to disable would be disabled on the CMS. Like if you don't want to show a bureau widget, which is a Tuesday thing, or inbox widget, or something like show magenta feature is something that would not be shown to metro users, right? Magenta status. So you can have these flags disabled on the metro app, and it would not be fetched and not be shown to those in that case.
But how to do in CMS? Like, can you show us?
I would show you guys. Let me open up the CMS. So I'll show you while this is loading, I'll show you a CMS ticket as well. Okay, TWCMS27, let's say. This is a random ticket I'm choosing right now. Okay, so you see these are all the feature flags which are required for this feature. So this feature would have, let's say, this is our user story. Okay, a user story which has all these requirements, and these requirements, we have these particular numbers, whatever, and we have all these particular screen, right? Now on these clicks, on these numbers, there can be multiple things which are configurable, right? So we have this CMS ticket, CMS 27. These are all the information which would be translatable. So these things which are all you can see here are translatables. Now these things, like let's say deep link, you want to create a contact number which can be changed in the future. It is configurable. Let's say you want to have a number which is right now it is 1234, and afterwards you can change it to something else. So these are things which can be configurable. So all these things would be put in the CMS and it would be configurable later. I'll show you an example from the CMS portal if I am able to log in. Okay, so I go to configurations, I go to T-World iOS Dev. In T-World iOS Dev, let's say I want to change it for version 8.2.0, and in the modules, on the home page, let's say I want to change up this enable inbox widget on home, which is basically in the data provider, it is in module.home.tuesdays, then enable image widget on home. So what I would do is I would go to modules, home, Tuesday. There would be this Tuesday Is there anything else? Where is that? Okay, this would be introduced in some future release then. Let me check. Module home, Tuesday. Then there is enable image widget on home. If I turn it as no and relaunch my app, it would be not be showing anymore. So we can change all these things from here. So we have commerce, we have different whether it is enabled or disabled. Then we have from billing, we have things like deep links. Let's say I want to create a button which can have different deep links attached to it. So we can have a deep link. Let's say I want to on the pay button. Let's say my pay button is supposed to trigger a deep link. I can configure that deep link here, and I can use it in the code. Similarly, we have let's say retry counts, timeout seconds, security source IDs, things like that can be configurable here as well. Any questions as of now?
How to add a new entry?
Yes, this was already existing, correct? Like how to
these are all already existing, correct? So to add a new entry, what you would want to do is you want to go to this default, we want to create a new key. Let's say my key is this module.hsi. So basically, if I want to make it in module section in the HSI, then subsection, let me open up that again. Da-da-da-da. So let's say I am creating this module in the home section. In the home section, I want to go to billing, and in the billing, I want to create a new thing called show magenta billing card, right? So what I would do is I would write module home billing show magenta billing card. I would choose it as a boolean. I would have a default value as false or true, whatever you want. I would have a description here. Description is usually our ticket number with what that boolean is supposed to do. So a little bit of description, and I would just click create here, and it would be created. So I'm not creating it right now because this was it would be added and we would have to delete it. But when you create it, it would show up here basically. Now for the things which could have the discussion we were having. So let's say I am previewing this. So let's say I am introducing this new button here. I can have a feature flag for this, whether it would be enabled or not. If it is enabled, we would go into this flow. Otherwise, we will not go into this flow, right? Let's say we go to this screen. Now for this screen, what are the things I would have in translations? So in translations, I would have manage wallet. Where did it go? Right. So I would have manage wallet in my translation number one. I would have save payment methods in my translation number two. I would have ending in with a dynamic value in my translation, because this is something which can come from translation as well. I would have edit in my translation. I would have add payment method in my translation. All these things would be coming from translation. This would come from API. In this particular screen, I would have edit card in my translation, name on card on my translation, card number in my translation. I would have a regex for this particular credit card. If it was enterable, I would have regex in my configuration.
Okay, I would have expiration date and zip code in my translation, because these could be in Spanish or in English. I would have all these in delete text in my translation as well. All these things we can have in translations. So these are Spanish and English configurable. So all these would be in translations as well. Now, let's say I want to have a special flow, as in there are these. I'm just taking an example. I am not sure if it makes sense or not. If we want to show this or not, like this update app autopay method, we want to disable this for a few versions or enable it for a few versions. We can have a special feature flag for this particular feature as well. So we can have feature flags for entry points, and we can have feature flags for anything inside the flow as well. Any questions so far?
Is it environment based flag, or is it generic for all the entities?
Yeah, it is environment based flags. Translations are something which is generic for all the environment, because that is controlled by product. So if you want to develop something and check whether it is working or not, we can always have those translations. And when we are creating those translations, we can change them, because while creating it, no one would in the production would already have it. So we can do our experimenting. Once that feature is QA tested and it is released, then we leave it up to the product to change those and configure those. And for the where is it? Oh, I think I closed that CMS window. I'll open up the CMS window again. So the configurations are basically environment related. You can have something enabled or disabled for a particular environment. So in the configuration, you see here, we have dev environment, we have production, we have staging, we have all these different. For Metro right now, there are two environments, because we did not know if we have any additional environments or not. So there is iOS dev and Android dev for Metro. And we can have it for an environment and for a particular version as well. So let's say I want to change something in a particular version of the app on a particular environment. We have that capability as well.
So dev debug, if you need to make any changes in dev debug, is there a environment called dev debug, or
yeah, so Metro iOS dev right now, the API's key for Metro iOS dev is in dev debug. If the country code is Metro and the environment is dev debug, then this particular API key is being used.
Okay.
Okay, I hope that clears up a few things. By the way, do we have Android team here as well?
Yeah, Neep and Rakiba from Android, Ashish.
All right.
Yeah. So, any other questions, Rakesh and Abhiram guys?
I have one question, it's not specific to this one, but what kind of CMS access you have? Like, what is your role in the CMS?
I have developer access.
Okay. So I think Shri, the developer access, what Ashish is having and whatever we got is something different.
I mean, did your role change, Surjit, after made you the
No, I don't see any changes.
You don't see any changes? Okay, let me see. No, at least I have a developer role. I'm not sure, let's see.
Because
but
we
I'm
need to
actually
get this back
yeah.
to these to Rakesh, Nabil, and everyone. So you need to know what kind of like accessing these modules and all these values. We need to see which kind of roles is having those kind of access.
Right. Yes, so everyone make sure. So, what we follow in DDDL is only a few handful people who have access to this, because we don't want to create any tickets which are not valid, or because those would be added and it's a hassle to get them deleted. And they should be similar in iOS and Android, so they should be in sync and agreed upon before we create those tickets.
That is agreed, Ashish, but we need to give at least one developer on each side.
Correct, correct, correct. That I think I think someone from CMS or someone from platform team would be able to give you guys the right access.
Hey, Surjit, I changed your role to developer. I'm not sure if it's... Yes, yeah, check it when I get a chance.
Don't change me anything.
Hmm?
Need to talk to the actual CMS guy. No. What is the current role? Because otherwise we will keep and they say, hey, why did you do that?
Okay, I already changed it. That is too late. Okay, so let's
so,
see what they say. Yeah,
I think Wednesday we have a
so,
meeting with public money.
Do you guys have access to Patronus? Do you guys have access
yeah,
to Patronus?
I have access to that one. Yeah, let me share my screen.
Okay,
moment,
so
yeah.
within Patronus, what you can
yeah.
do is you can say edit a particular person's role to make them. Give
yeah.
them access to multiple things. So let's say go to
can you see my screen? I'm like, so basically like so
yes.
consortium thread, I made him a developer right now. I'm like
right. So,
yeah, so
right now he has this one module one in which he has access to all these different things like create translation, update translation. In configuration, he just has access to see the configuration. If you click over here, now you can take different things.
Okay,
configuration
can
update, can view, can create, whatever, all these things.
Okay. So I just need to, okay, let's see if I change this one and see if we can get access to it.
But this is a super bar and there are a lot of things you can do with this.
Okay.
We have apps which are in production and they can potentially go down if you
but I think sure. Okay. I'm like, you want us to change this one? I'm like, because like
You can save this and give access. Just just be cautious when you are changing things.
Yeah,
it.
I think for us, I think the biggest thing is we have only access to the Metro modules on. I'm not sure if that does that mean anything or not. I'm like, if I go to the page,
so,
I'm like, I don't know. If I go to configurations, it shows me only these. I'm not sure.
Okay.
And then how does this translate to that configuration part? I'm not sure whether they get enforced, whether it is part of the Metro or not. But I'm not sure.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Let's see. Maybe as Surjit, now we just
take
it. I
think
Surjit
would
have
all the access to create those keys, values, update them, whatever I could do. Surjit would have all this access.
Okay. Okay. Then anything else? Yes. Or.
Srinivas, we just have one question. So. If we declare a new key, so we have to do it for both Android and iOS for different, because I saw like there's two environment for Android and iOS.
Yeah, it looks like we need to create two different keys for both iOS and Android.
Okay. And like currently, they've been the.
One second, I think. Yeah, just I'm not sure.
Sorry, I got
dropped. Yeah, I think that's what I thought. Ashish, yeah. So basically, like if we have a key, let's say for the payment screen or anything, we need to create for both Android and iOS, right? The same key?
No, so if you create that key at one place, it would be automatically be created in all the instances.
My bad. I thought we could need to create on both, yeah.
Okay, and so in the current T-Life app, they also had also have the future flag, so we will have, because we also have our own future flag, so we will have double future flag, and this will be like a lot of if else check. Is that okay?
I mean, the feature flag would be, so we have one code base. So all the feature flags which are already there are in the configuration file that you guys have, or in the Metro instance that you have. Any additional flows that gets created would have additional feature flags. Does that answer your question? I mean, I'm not sure if I got your question.
Yeah, I got it. Because like later when we have our own futures and then the existing TLive future is there, and when we like make some changes, so we don't know if maybe like cause the potential issues later, and that's just really tricky to like debug or figure it out later.
Right, so we would have feature flags, like the old ones and the new ones. The feature flags would get updated as per the features get added to the system. We hope that there are certain features, and BFF is designed in a way that the feature is similar in TLive and in Metro. So we create a feature once and it gets updated in both Metro and in TLive, such as our router stuff and HSI stuff.
For that, so we have to declare like using the same key for both TLive and Metro?
Right. So it would be a feature and it would be created in a way that it is behind that feature flag, and if you want to enable it on the TLive app as well, you can do that. And our BFF APIs, in theory, would be created in such a way that everything would work out of the box.
Okay, yeah, so I think, Srijit, so we need to sync up with the TLive app, like when they have a new feature or something. Because whenever
that will be an ongoing effort, right? I mean, it is not that, I mean, like, yeah, it has to be an ongoing effort between the TLive app and these things, yeah, when they merge.
Okay.
I mean, like, yeah. When we deploy the code, yeah, it will be an ongoing effort. It's not that we are siloed or anything, it has to be a combined effort.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, that's just my concern.
Okay, any other questions? Okay, I think if not, we can wrap up this call. Yeah, thanks a lot, Ashish. Thanks for your help.
Alright, I think we can create a group, a Teams group for any questions that you have, that you can either post your queries or something like that, so we don't have to wait an entire day for the session. That would be more helpful.
Sure. Yeah, sure. We'll create a group.
There is a group already, we can use that as well, or if you want to create anyone.
Yeah, that's what I thought. I mean, we already had a group, we can reuse keep using that one. If not, we'll, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Thanks, everyone. Yeah. All right.
You guys.
Thanks. Yeah. Bye.
Yeah. Thank you. Bye. tiêu bà gọi đò gọi ơi hỏi thấy đâu mất tiêu mất tích trời sáng họp mệt quá đóng gì tù đuôi
nghe như bị nghe sấm ông nội nào nó khó nghe bà cố
cái giọng Ấn Độ nó vậy á giống như nước ngoài nó nghe giọng Việt Nam mình nói tiếng Anh cũng vậy nó Ấn Độ nó dễ nghe lắm rồi đó ban đầu mình nghe không quen thôi nó vậy chứ sau này nghe riết liền nó nói tiếng Anh cũng đơn giản mà đỡ hơn mấy Mỹ bản địa ở đây tối ăn cái gì vậy
bánh mì hấp
là ăn sao cả
em vào đó em cũng biết á xong rồi em mình nhờ anh chị út anh mới biết cái món bánh thấm cái đó
nhưng mà ở ngoài
này cái bánh mì đó nó cắt nửa ra xong rồi trên đó nó có nhân là ở trên nó đen có nhân là củ sắn với lại thịt là cái đó là nhân đó nó giống kiểu là ướp sẵn xào chín ướp sẵn hết rồi xong đem bánh mì đi hấp xíu cho nó nóng rồi ăn quấn với bạch dầu
là ở ngoài giòn trong nóng không cái nào đúng không? Có thêm hàng lớn chứ phải một thằng, hôm nay mới nhận ra là anh có tới hai thằng lớn, chết mẹ. Bây giờ phải chỉ nó làm như thế nào.
Mới
hả? Ừ.
Mới tuyển vô
à? À, vốn tuyển vô mà tụi nó ở Ấn Độ, nó làm remote đó.
Lại
Ấn. Hả? Thế là tụi nó làm là muối Ấn Độ, Ấn Độ mà, nói này Ấn Độ mà. Thằng kia bị đuổi rồi.
Ủa?
Nó đuổi lâu rồi.
Không có một cái người ăn lắm. Mà đợt mà ăn đây mà nó giúp ăn thì nó hỗ trợ đâu.
Nhiều thằng đó, nhưng mà thằng đó hình như nó là thằng nó bị đuổi rồi.
Còn gì thằng nữa?
Ừ?
Ông cái thằng mà bữa anh kêu ăn nghỉ xong rồi nó anh làm bó cho nó.
Thằng đó, thằng đó con, thằng đó Bangladesh, cũng kế bên Ấn Độ. cái mail em chưa check. Tao không nói gì luôn rồi, anh gửi trong kia. Anh cũng quên lẫn luôn.
Em cũng quên.
Ai ghê. Mai đi rút hả?
Ồ.
Không gửi gì hết, gửi tiền thôi. Gửi tiền không muốn mua, mua rồi gì nữa.
Gì?
Nhưng không gửi gì hết, không mua gì hết.
Là sao?
Em,
không nghe được Phúc
đâu. Em, Kiều không gửi
sao?
Gì hết. Không có mua cái gì hết.
À, chờ nha, không có bông bông hoa hết. Nghe
hoa,
sao?
Hoa có ăn được không? Hoa có uống được không? Gửi tiền nó muốn mua gì mua, muốn ăn gì ăn, sướng cho trời. Thích màu mè hoa hẹ. Giờ nó như ở Mỹ nó trả lương cao mệt quá, sao giờ nó mướn thằng bên Ấn Độ qua không mệt. Nó làm trái múi giờ mấy khứa này.
Ủa là sao trái múi giờ?
Thì tụi nó làm giờ Ấn Độ mà, nó làm tới 12 giờ nó đi ngủ rồi, nó còn đâu nữa. Ý là nó đã làm ban đêm rồi đó nha, nó làm cũng tới.
Ủa nhưng mà sao tụi nó được làm bên đó?
Tuyển vô nó khác. Anh tuyển vô xưa anh làm ở đây nó khác. Mà cái thay đổi đó nó khó lắm. Nó không cho mình đổi đâu. Cái đó là đăng ký mà lúc nó được tuyển vào luôn á. Tuyển vô là nó là làm từ bên đó. Tại vì với lại á, công ty phải có trụ sở bên cái nước sở tại nữa. Để mà khi làm việc ngoài là mọi cái thứ, tại vì làm việc ngoài nó không có bị trả thuế cho nước Mỹ đâu. Tại vì nó đâu phải lãnh lương trên đất Mỹ đâu, nó đâu có bị đóng thuế ở đây đâu, nó phải có một cái công ty chấp pháp nhân ở cái nước sở tại ở Ấn Độ đó, để nó làm về thủ tục giấy tờ rồi trả lương này kia bên đó. Mấy cái việc đó nó